Hi guys, so today I am going to show you how to crumb coat a cake. And it sounds exactly like what it is. So what you're doing is stacking your cake layers and doing a very thin coat of buttercream or whatever frosting you choose to use around the outside just to keep the crumbs in, so when you're doing your final layer of buttercream, you do not get any crumbs in there. So I have my cake all baked and ready to go. I have it leveled off. I'm doing a cookies and cream cake here. And this one I made 2 days ago, sealed it up, froze it, and now it's been thawing for about 20-30 minutes, and so it's pretty soft. And so we're gonna start. So I'm just doing a whipped American buttercream, and I'm just gonna go around, and I put it in a silicone piping bag. You can do this, you can do it in a Ziploc bag, you can do it any which way. And I just add a decent amount of buttercream on there. And then I have just a Wilton offset spatula. I'm gonna just go around there, try to make it as smooth as possible. And now I'm going to add just crushed up Oreos on top of this. Now I'm going to add my next layer. Make sure it is even. I'm going to do the same. Take my offset spatula again, run it around, make it as smooth as possible. I'm going to add more crushed Oreos on this layer. And I do all my cakes three layers unless requested otherwise. I don't do anything less than three, but I do at least three, sometimes four, five, six. Okay, I'm gonna add my last layer on. And this one I am going to flip it over, make sure it's all even. Okay, and when it is, I'm going to fill my piping bag up. More frosting. Right, now that that's full, again, I'm gonna go around the cake and do a very thin layer. And here where there's a gap, just go ahead and pipe frosting in that little space. And I do use Esther Cakes for all my cones. This is my Smooth Hound. And if you use code TREATSBYTAY at checkout, you get 17% off. And I'm just going to go around. I'm giving it a little bit of pressure, but not too much. That's what's coming off. And then the little spaces that aren't filled with any buttercream, I'm gonna take my offset spatula and just fill those in. Scrape it off, just some on the top. Some of the top of the sides right here where you can see some of the cake. You don't want to be able to see any of your cake layers. All right, now I'm going to run this under hot water for about 10 seconds and wipe it off with a clean cloth. Thank you. and just go around the cake very lightly and smooth it out. Get all that excess buttercream off. Once again, if you see any little patches where there's it's not even, just go ahead and fill those in with your offset spatula. Use the frosting off of your comb. And this smooth layer does not need to be perfect. It is just your crumb coat, so you should be going over it again. So if you are wanting to do a naked cake, this is pretty much exactly what it is. It's just kind of an unfinished cake to where you can see the layers of the cake. When I do it a little bit differently though, and I don't add buttercream all the way around right at the start. Now that your sides are smooth enough, everything's filled in, there's no cake layers showing, I'm gonna go ahead and scrape in with your spatula. Just pull the sides in so it keeps that sharp edge. And you have a crumb coat. So now before I do decorate anything, I do pop this in the fridge for about 10-15 minutes and let the buttercream harden a little bit so your crumb coat doesn't smear with your other coat. And there you have it.